forecast is ugly in Houston, but we're bringing you tonight's game under the roof of Minute Maid Park. Game two of the World Series between the LA Dodgers and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, an important ballgame coming up here in Game 2.
Yeah, it was a good start for these guys at home. They did what they needed to do in the opening game, and this crowd really showed up and made a difference as well. Should be an electric atmosphere again, so we'll see if the guys on the field can feed off it and take a commanding lead in this series.
The buildup to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series Baseball on the show. And we'll have it for you next. Lance McCullers is on the mound for Game 2. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
And now here is Mookie Betts. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Donnie extends nicely, and this ball driven to right field and deep. And this one is gone. A home run. Solo home run there for Mookie. And the Dodgers strike first, 1-0.
You talk about setting the tone for your team offensively. Everyone's allowed to relax now, pass the baton mentality. And if that's any indication where these next nine innings are going, buckle up, fans.
At the plate, Corey Seager. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left the yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
A little early, and now it's even at 2-2.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker-changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
Base is empty here with nobody out. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Another 2-2 offering. Oh, he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
So now to the plate, Justin Turner. The count now at 2-1. Into the windup and the pitch. High and deep down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Bases are empty, one man out. That's a swinging strike three in the dirt. Castro gathers, makes the throw to first, two down. And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger. Bases are empty here with two men out. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot.
Bottom of the first coming up from Minute Maid Park, and LA's off to an early 1-0 lead. Walker Buehler will be on the bump for game two of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a 5-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
So up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Right there, but you know, as a base stealer, when you're in the box like that, you want to protect your money makers, right? You don't want anything around your knees or your feet, so he was fortunate to get out of the way of that one.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive, still 2-2. Now the pitch. Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat, trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
To the plate now, Alex Bregman. A ball and two strikes now.
Two strikes.
One out, nobody on. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
Going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Ready on 1-2. Rolled slowly to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3. They still trail 1-0. Second inning set to go, and next will be the speedy catcher, Will Smith. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2. Two and two to the Dodgers catcher. Here now the 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Brantley is under it. He's got it one away.
That is good. The first baseman.
Time for a look at the Stros on base. In the outfield, Michael Brantley. This guy broke the Indians franchise record for consecutive games without an error in 2013. Has great range and is very sure-handed out there. Always going to make the play.
Standing in now, Max Muncy. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. Swing and a little tapper. That's a foul ball. Bases are empty, one man out. Full count now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And it's fouled away. pitch one more time. Fouled off. Fouled away. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
At the plate now, A.J. Pollock. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Smoked on the ground up the middle. There is Altuve. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. So to go quietly here in this half inning. On now to the bottom of the second. The Dodgers lead it 1-0. Into the box, Carlos Correa. His career numbers in this matchup. He's a perfect 2-for-2. He also has one home run. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. Correa in front, three balls and a strike.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Now it'll be Yordan Alvarez. Correa gets his lead at first, nobody out. Runner goes for second. Pitch outside, the throw. And in fact, there will be no throw as he loses the handle there on the transfer. Here's the 2-1. Ball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. Called strike two. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Dodgers have the early 1-0 advantage as we play the second. Just missed with the 2-2 count, and it runs full now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
payoff pitch home. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
So next to hit is Kyle Tucker trying here to plate the tying run from second. All even now, 2-2. First and second now, one man out. Hit hard on the ground is short. And the Astros have their first hit of the contest. And the run will score from second as this ball game is tied one apiece.
Sometimes you just got to trust your hands. That pitch probably wasn't even in the zone, and he was able to fight it off for a base hit.
In now, Miles Straw. There's ball four.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Next up for the Stros, Jason Castro. Certainly a big moment in this game. Bases loaded, tie score. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Gone! It's a grand slam. So he promptly unloads the bases with that one, and it's suddenly a 5-1 ball game.
Wow, I can't imagine what he's feeling right now. To hit a home run in the World Series is special. To hit a grand slam in the World Series, I don't think there's too many people that can say that.
Stepping in now, Jose Altuve. And he fouls this one off. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Bellinger is there now, and he has it, two gone.
Third baseman number two, Alex Bregman.
So the bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Ball.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. So they put up a big number in the inning as five crossed the plate. And this was the biggie here, the grand slam home run. We've played two. It's the Astros 5 and the Dodgers 1. Top of the third set to get underway. And here's Matt Beatty now.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at bat at a time.
Again, a 1-2. Hit softly down the line at first. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
That is not the second baseman. Gavin.
Next, here is Gavin Lux. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, there's the perfect pitch right there, the straight changeup. He hadn't used it yet in this at bat, and what does he do? He uses it, pulls the string, and gets the big strikeout.
To the plate now, Mookie Betts. 2-1 now to Mookie.
Boy, they've been just getting shut down right here. Been a while since they've even had a runner on. So I think it's time to start looking for ways to make some things happen. Drop a bunt, get up on the plate, something.
Now the 2-1.
Oh, that's off the plate.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that. He's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
And the count will be full. Payoff pitch home. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
You know, with two outs and nobody on, that's the last thing you want to do on the mound. That really gives the opposition some hope that they can do something with this inning.
Digging in will be Corey Seager. First time up, he went down looking.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled and just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
I can't imagine that pitcher was trying to put it right over the heart of the plate. Thank God he took that pitch right there, or he'd be getting one back from the umpire.
Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. Bouncer to the left side. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Dodgers leave one. They're down 5-1. And we're back for the bottom of the third. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros offense with Houston's manager. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Bottom of the third now, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. One is taken for ball two. Lifted down the line and left. Coming in is Pollock, and they can't run it down.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss, and another strikeout.
Into the box, Carlos Correa. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. One out, nobody on. And that is off the first base bag. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Yeah, some guys have the ability to rise to the occasion, while some guys shrink away when it matters the most. Well, this guy is a gamer. He's been on fire since the postseason started, and after that hit, it looks like he doesn't plan on stopping anytime soon.
So now to the plate, Yordan Alvarez. Drilled on the ground to short. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Now that first baseman, Yulieski. Gurriel.
Stepping in next, Yuli Gurriel. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Set to deal on 2-2. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Astros leave one. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Now to the plate, here is Justin Turner. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Altuve at second. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
The center fielder, 35. Cody Bellinger.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger, grounded out in his last at bat. 5-1 our score as we play the fourth here. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Now he sends a high, deep drive toward the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there.
Just not able to let that breaking ball travel enough right there. You could see his eyes light up when that popped out of the pitcher's hands, and he just hooked it foul.
Sinker misses ball four.
This is only their second base runner of the game after that earlier hit. Tough to score when you don't have anyone on base, so we'll see if they can get something going here.
Next to dig in, Will Smith. Flied out in his first at-bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. Hit out towards second. Altuve to his right. He has it. The second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. The Astros lead it 5-1. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Kyle Tucker. The 1-1 home is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two.
Usually you see chases outside the zone on off speed stuff like sliders, breaking balls and changeups. But to chase a fastball that far outside the zone tells me this hitter's not seeing it well at all.
High in the air out to center field. Bellinger is there and he has it for the first out.
The batter, number three.
Next to stand in is Miles Straw. Worked a walk his first time up. The 1-2. Now a fastball runs inside and drills him. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
And I'll tell you, this is the last guy in the lineup you want to put on base for free. He's probably feeling a little salty after getting drilled, and he's got speed to burn, so look for him to try and make something happen out there.
Standing in now, Jason Castro. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. Now a move over to first. Runner back safely. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Pollock is back to the track as he takes it for out number two.
Now batting, second baseman, Jose
Altuve. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve. One and two now.
Hey, he's done an amazing job of settling down. Two innings ago, I thought they were going to run him out of here. But now he's close to posting two shutout innings as a response.
Strong is off of first with two away. Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. One left for Houston. They're up 5-1. And we're back in Houston. Welcome back to Minute Maid Park as we check in with Heidi.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. The 1-1. A shot to second base and handled for the first out.
The left unit, 11, AJ Pollock.
Next to hit is AJ Pollock, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Grounder down the line at third. And there are two away now.
Now batting, designated hitter, Matt Beatty.
Matt Beatty stepping in. He's 0-for-1 thus far. A 1-1.
We got two balls, one strike.
It's a 5-1 game here in inning number five.
That's
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
One thing that could nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at bat here.
The 3-1. And he loses him on a breaking ball.
Wow, I'm not sure what they were afraid of in this at bat. The count moved to 3-2, and they didn't even challenge him there. I can understand being careful with some hitters, but not that guy. He'll happily take the walk.
The batter will be Gavin Lux, and we'll see if they can make him pay for the two-out walk, always considered a big no-no, of course. One run, just one hit. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. One left for L.A. They're down here 5-1. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Here now the 2-2. Is laid off up for ball number three.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Here's Michael Brantley. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Giving chase is Bellinger. He gets there, and that's the second out.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Here's Carlos Correa now. Now here's the pitch.
Two balls, one strike, the count.
Now a swing and another fly ball here as things are getting busy out there in Central. Bellinger able to track it down for the third out. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They lead this one though 5-1. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and standing in is the veteran outfielder Mookie Betts. Grounded straight into the shift on the left side. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Here's Corey Seager. No hits to this point. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Lined into left center, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Boy, Dero, anytime a lefty takes that pitch on the outer third and drives it the other way, you have to be awfully impressed.
Yeah, you have to be. It reminds me of Will Clark back in the day taking that ball the other way. You have to be able to play with the whole field to have success in the big leagues.
Next for the Dodgers, Justin Turner. He's 0-2 with a strikeout in this one. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. We're in the sixth inning now of a 5-1 ball game. Turner in front at three balls and a strike.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
It swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And that's in there. Base hit. They'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Here comes the Astros skipper up out of the Houston dugout, and he's looking to the bullpen here, so it would appear that's all for his starter tonight. He'll wind up lasting just one out into the sixth inning, but he'll leave with the lead and was effective in this one. Christian Javier takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. Now there are two on with only one away.
Number 53, Christian Javier.
Into the box now, Cody Bellinger, and it's fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Tucker waits on it. And he makes the catch for the second out.
The batter, the catcher, Will.
So two gone now for the Dodgers in the sixth, and that brings up Will Smith. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Into the corner and slicing foul. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
Well, the tying run looms on deck, so keeping this guy off the base is essential. In danger of walking him right here, though.
The 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Dodgers strand a couple. They're down 5-1. Tony Gonsolin enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and stepping in the long ball threat, Yordan Alvarez. The 1-1 home. Barely misses off the inside corner. 2-2. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now, as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Here now the 2-2. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. A full count, three balls and two strikes.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Heading out towards shallow right. On the move is Betts, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down.
The first patient, number 10, Ulieski.
Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
Weak grounder back to the mound. And there's out number two.
The right fielder, number 30.
Next, it'll be Kyle Tucker, a hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. The 1-1 home is laid off of down and in.
Now, 2-1.
To 2-2 now.
Count 2-2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor, you swing at a pitch that bad? Not good.
The 2-2. Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. They're up 5-1. And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. He comes in 0-2 thus far. And a good take there, as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Up next to the Dodgers. The left fielder.
Now at the plate, A.J. Pollock. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ballgame.
Ready with two balls and a strike.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
3-1 is in there for a full count now, 3-2.
Wow, I'm shocked the hitter took it right there. That's a well-executed pitch down in the zone to try and get that double play.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Stepping in now, Matt Beatty.
That ball
down low, two balls and a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a hard liner to center field. Strong is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now that second baseman, Gavin Lux.
Digging in next, Gavin Lux. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate. Muncy, the runner at first, with two gone. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball.
A couple of strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Popped him up. Correa is there. And the inning is over. Dodgers lead one. They're down here 5-1. Last half of the seventh here. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Miles Straw. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Not a bad spot to miss right there. Much rather have it run inside than out over the plate where the hitter can do a lot of damage.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
From 0-2 to 3-2, what a great at-bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hits this one hard the other way. Scooped up. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Now that the catcher, Jason Castro.
Jason Castro will stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Now the 1-1 pitch. He's in there for the second strike. Seventh inning here in a 5-1 ball game. And a splitter swung on to miss that time, and that'll be out number two.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you can spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1-2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
At the plate now, Jose Altuve. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. Alex Bregman would be next. The 3-1. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. And no one will get this one. Five runs, just three hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
And that'll bring up the former first-rounder, Alex Bregman. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 1-1 misses for the second ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
From the belt, the pitch offered at and missed. Here's the throw. Well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
Now a ground ball to Seager is short. He's right there, and the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. Astros lead one. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Mookie Betts back at the plate now. The entire offense so far with the solo homer he hit earlier.
Does a great job of knocking it down with a dive and then a good feed and a flip to the pitcher, just like you work on it in spring training, PFP, pitcher's fielding practice.
To the plate now, Corey Seager. Fouled off. Here comes the 1-2. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double. Just an absolute laser that time. Screaming off the bat, if you will. And ShowTrack tells us it went out at 112 miles an hour. Those are the line drives you can hear as they go by. Justin Turner, well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Seager leads off second with one gone in the inning. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Tucker is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Cody Bellinger at the plate now. Full count to Bellinger. Three balls, two strikes. Will Smith would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Now the 3-2 pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. 5-1 our score as we play the eighth. He spoils another one and we'll do it again. Payoff pitch on its way. And this is taken here for ball four. Just the second walk he's allowed into his eighth inning of work.
Wow, if that's not a strike, I don't know what is. I know these umps have a tough job. I get it. We'll see if he gets the next borderline call or if there are any makeup calls coming up.
Pedro Baez trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away.
Baez.
Here now is Will Smith. And, Dan, this could be a real make-or-break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's one and two. Two down, runners at first and second. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Dodgers strand a couple. They're down 5-1. Now to bat, Michael Brantley. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. And this will be fouled away. Now another 1-2. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Swing and a liner. Bellinger patrolling center makes the play, one out.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count. Yordan Alvarez will be next. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Going back is Bellinger. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Yordan.
Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Two out, nobody on. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Ready on 3-1, here it comes. Ripped down the line. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. And he is in the second with a two-out double. That was not a good pitch, but he handled it nicely, guys.
Yeah, the pitcher's got to wonder what he has to do to get past this guy. That pitch was off the plate, but he showed great reach, gets good extension, and drives it for a two-bagger.
So now to the plate, Yuli Gurriel. And he's going to make him throw him something here. 3-2 now. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Gurriel swings, and it's hit very well out to left. Pollock looking up. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A two-run job by Yuli Gurriel, as it's now a six-run ball game.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Standing in now, Kyle Tucker. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Upper part of the zone there, but taken for a strike. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
Well, no one really likes getting plunked by a pitch, but as long as it doesn't do too much damage, most guys will take it any day. A free pass can be a big deal if the guys behind you can make it hurt for the pitcher.
So now here is Miles Straw. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Don't want to forget about it. Tucker leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Fielded cleanly. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. Astros play two on the two-run home run. Last coming up here for the Dodgers, it's the Astros 7 and the Dodgers 1. Joe Smith comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 38, Joe Smith.
So stepping in is Max Muncy. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down two games to none if they can't rally. Somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. The 2-2. Shot weakly to the left. fouled away. The 2-2 one more time.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count. It just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Next up is A.J. Pollock. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. One and fouls this one off. The runner at first with no outs here. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Now to the plate is the Dodgers' designated hitter, Matt Beatty, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Ground ball foul down the left side. Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Runner at first here, one man out. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. At the plate now is Gavin Lux, and these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb, but hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden this thing feels doable.
Hit hard on the ground towards second, and that's through into center field. Base hit, long throw to the plate, and he is safe at the plate, taking a chance down a bunch, but it's a 7-2 contest now.
Boy, that's an aggressive send there, Dior, because this outfielder has a very strong throwing arm.
Yeah, and when you're sitting in the hitter's meeting, that's stuff they get. So every base runner is on notice, knowing that this guy's got one of the strongest arms in the league, but they challenged him, and it worked.
Steve Cishek answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one.
Number 31, Steve Cishek.
At the plate, Mookie Betts. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them a pitch that can't do much with becomes easier.
In now, Corey Seager. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, one of the keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home. So this was a big win to win at home in front of their home crowd.
This evening's ends at a 7-2 finish. Houston get the win to jump out to a 2-0 series lead. Lance McCullers pitches well enough to get the W. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 7 runs, 5 hits. No errors, they left 4 men on base. For the Dodgers, 2 runs on 5 hits. No errors, they left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 14 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Minute Maid Park, 41,168. The Astros thank you for attending and remind you to please drive home safely.